Welcome to a special Christmas edition of the Pop Culture History Podcast. My name is Mike Larkin, and joining me as always is my savage amiga, the one and only Miss Brittany Savage. Miss Brittany Savage, how are you?
I'm Holly, and I'm jolly because Christmas time. How are you?
I'm good. First and foremost, I don't know what it is with you and Christmas, because I see it's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the fall thing. You know what it is? Sometimes I'm thinking you're either extra perky with some coffee. I don't know if you've been having a little cheery, had a little some of the eggnog, man, because you're very perky around this time of year. And I love it, because I'm a Christmas guy myself. But my God, woman, decaf.
You know I don't drink coffee.
Okay. Well, did you have a little alcohol or something?
I don't drink too much of the eggnog. No, I'm just kidding.
All right. Did you have some alcoholic beverages or something, man? Did you cheer every time you heard? Did you like have cheers and friggin' just, you know, celebrate with a shot of something every time you heard a Christmas song? What's the dealio, man? You were out your mind.
I mean, I grew up with, I don't know, my parents, like, you know, they always went all out and tried their absolute hardest during Christmas time. So growing up for me, Christmas time is always a special time because there was so much magic behind Christmas. You know, like they always made it special. So especially now that I have Brooke, and now I feel like I've become my parents in a way. I just feel like I need to make everything magical and everything just needs to be a fun time. It's Christmas time, right? So you're supposed to have fun. And especially given that it's 2020 and everything that's been happening in 2020, I feel like now's the time to be absolutely positive and have good vibes and just remember that there's still the spirit of Christmas in the air. So, spirit.
Beautifully said. I truly mean, I'm just busting your chops. But for me, with Christmas, my mom always made it special. You know, used to have the Santa Claus. She would put out the cookies for me. You know, like, you know, kids still believing in Santa Claus. You know, very committed to the lights. You know, my grandparents and were always into it. My grandmother, God rest her soul, the stubborn woman that she was, used to go out and shovel the snow. I'm like, what are you doing, you crazy old woman? I digress. No, it's one of those things where it was great because for me, you know, going to Jones Beach, going to the light shows, just going around seeing everybody's house decorating the house, just home movies, camcorders, the whole nine. It's a great time for Christmas, you know what I'm saying? And for me, I also look at it from a stance of, like you said, the season of giving. Everybody's happy, everybody's having fun, everybody's getting together, and that's what it needs to be about. And like you said, so eloquently put it, I mean, you got your little Brookie there, you got your little Minnie, she's having fun, she's helping you decorate the tree, putting up the lights. It's that camaraderie and the overall family, you know, behind it, you know?
Absolutely. I just feel like for me, it's all about giving and seeing the expression and the look on people's face when they're receiving something that you put a lot of thought and effort into, regardless of what it is, because I'm not the type of person that could just hand somebody whatever. You know, I have to actually put some thought into it. That's why a lot of times I start my shopping earlier than most people, just because I have, I've thought about it for such a long period of time, like, oh, this is what I can get that person. So for me, it's all about just being thoughtful and being giving. It's not about receiving. I personally don't like really getting gifts. I mean, obviously, if I get a gift, I'm very awkward if I get something. I'm just like, oh, thank you, because I don't know what to do, you know, because I'm just so used to loving the expression on everybody's face. So for me, that's what it's mainly about, is just giving, especially for children who have nothing in the world and stuff like that. And then, just like you said, having your family around you, that's what's really meaningful and what the holiday is really about. And then like the Christmas dinner and like tradition and just baking and obviously Christmas movies and music. My absolute favorite.
We'll get to that because Kaysen exposed the fact that you watch whack-ass, crack-ass, friggin' Hallmark movies all the damn time, you nutty, nutty woman, you. And also number two, I just like to add, let the record be shown that Brittany Savage is awkward, as if we didn't already know that. You and your awkwardness. That's what that is. So no. But I mean, for real. Before we even get into the Christmas stuff, I just had to mention that because as much as I love Case and Mr. Hey, I live around the block from Pam's Ice Cream. Gotta support your local businesses. Hi, JT. Anyway, I digress. So that's my buddy. I can do that. I love that man. But no, it's one of those things. He's going to hate me for that. But no, it's one of those things where I look at it from a stance, Miss Brittany Savage, where you do love you some Hallmark stuff. And don't get me wrong, the Hallmark channel is great, but can I just say there are some corny-ass Christmas movies on there. I'll be honest, I'm not even watching the Lifetime. I would rather watch the Lifetime Movie Network, where it's like the Slay and all that stuff, where it's like the Killings on Christmas or whatever. It's like the Slay Marathon. I forgot what it's called, but goddamn, man, those are more intriguing than just the happy, holly jolly, if you will, Christmas movies on the Lifetime. I don't know why, but those are just more intriguing, even though I love Christmas and the fact that... Talk about the Hallmark stuff for a second, man, because how are you sure you didn't see any of those movies that Kaysen so eloquently put on Facebook? You sure about that?
Okay, I admitted that I saw like what, three of them?
Yeah, something like that.
However, if they were any of the Candace Cameron Bure films, I would have seen every single one of them. 100%. I watch all of her Christmas films because she is like the queen of Christmas, right? That's what they call her.
And Jodie Sheehan.
Every movie that she's been in, I've watched, and I actually liked every single one of them. This year, as far as Hallmark goes, I have not watched one Hallmark film, if I'm being honest. I've been mainly watching Home Alone 2 a lot with Brooke because that's her actual favorite Christmas movie now. She's obsessed with Macaulay Culkin, not actual Macaulay Culkin, but Kevin McAllister, because he's a little creepy now. So she likes Kevin. So we've been watching a lot of that. And then there's this movie called The Mistletoes that is my absolute favorite Christmas movie. So I've watched that about 12 times already.
Hey, man. Can't go wrong with Home Alone 2. Eating the pizza, having the Pepsi in the friggin' car. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Watching The Grinch and then Tim Curry. Bingo. Yep. Yep.
Oh, my God. So great. So great. But my favorite is Home Alone 1 because it's the original.
Okay. Well, as long as we don't get into Home Alone 3 territory, I think we're good.
Oh, terrible.
Terrible.
I mean, I still watched it, but I don't love it because it's not the original cast.
Well, no, you have Alex D. Linz coming in, and I'm like, friggin' Alex D. Linz, and no disrespect to him. I remember seeing him, and well, here's the thing that used to play on Disney a lot of time. 2005, I believe it was, Full Court Miracle, the only movie that they showed during Hanukkah. You know, it was white Jewish kids, you know, playing basketball, being managed by a black coach. There you go. Take that plot with you. So it's one of those things where it's just like that was their one Hanukkah movie that he was in. And he was in a lot of the Disney movies like Max Keeble's Big Move and the Jenny Project with the chimp. So, I mean, it's one of those things where it's like, yo, you're replacing Macaulay Culkin with this kid and it absolutely sucked. But then for me, I love the first one, too, just because, you know, he gets the neighbor and his family back together, which is absolutely lovely. Again, we talk about the camaraderie and everybody coming together for Christmas. And Home Alone 2, he's in New York and it's just funny. And he meets the woman with the pigeons, who was also an Angels in the Outfield, for God's sake, as Maggie, friggin' taking care of everybody at the orphanage. I tried to see Angels. I really tried. Go back and watch that movie, people. But yeah, I mean, it's just there's something special about those two films. And I concur with you on that. Like, for me, like, I love the Christmas Carol specials. I love Christmas-themed episodes. Like, Kenan and Kel growing up had a great one where he gives the kid who's less fortunate a bicycle, which I thought was very, very cool. And, you know, you have so many Christmas-themed episodes, and it's just, it's good. It's really good. There's so many great Christmas-themed episodes. Boy Meets World, go ahead.
I was just going to say, don't forget Boy Meets World, Sean with the basketball.
Yeah. Okay. Besides that one, I mean, well, first and foremost, that was a whole lot of meaning because, you know, I don't want your charity. And besides that one, that was very, yes.
Sean and Angela, that's what you're going to talk about?
Well, that one, and then Corey. And, you know, what, you know, Topanga and the eggnog.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be honest with you. That would probably be something that you would do, Miss Topanga Savage over here. You probably make someone go out like myself and get your eggnog because you're like that. You're ornery a little bit.
You definitely need your eggnog.
Well, I mean, I'm just saying. It might be a little picky, a little ornery like Topanga was. A little bit.
Oh, for sure.
All right. I called that one right on the spot there. So
wow.
Hey man, truth is truth, Brittany Savage. So it was one of those things where like those iconic episodes, like we mentioned, Boy Meets World, Full House, when there was like a couple ones that were very good, you know, when they get snowed in, there was the one where Vicky comes back as the Santa Claus. There's a lot of great stuff. Mickey Rooney, yeah man. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think that's when they got locked in the store.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Stephanie and Michelle.
Yep. And yep. A yep. Oh,
and for me,
I know. And for me, I also, you got Christmas movies like Twas the Night on Disney Plus, where you have friggin' Bryan Cranston in there. You got The Ultimate Christmas Present with Halle Hirsch and Brenda Song, one of her first movies before she was London Tipton on The Suite Life of Zach Goody. There's so many great Christmas movies. Like from the 80s, I remember Santa Claus, the movie with Dudley Moore, the Santa Claus franchise with Tim Allen. There's so many good stuff that really just bring out the Christmas cheer. And of course, I'd be remiss if I didn't talk about Elf, man.
Elf. Buddy, Elf. Of course. Elf is like the best. It's hysterical. So funny.
You like maple syrup too? Woo, there it is. There it is. I'm in love, and I don't care who knows it. Yes.
Hope you find your dad.
Yeah, bye, buddy. Hope you find your dad. So, okay, here's where I also get pissed. Before I get pissed, I got to talk about it. Personally, I sent you this GIF because, you know, you see, I know you, and I know how perky you are. So I figured I'd sent you this GIF. You are Will Ferrell. You are Buddy the Elf running around the friggin' automatic door, just running around in circles going, ah, that's you.
It's so true.
Yes, I sent that to Miss Savage in a messenger, and she just wrote back, yup, LOL. See? See? So, well.
It's a good film. Have you ever seen the movie Just Friends?
Isn't that the one with Ashton Kutcher?
Ew. No. Ryan Reynolds.
Ryan Reynolds? First of all, what do you mean, ew, no? I know Ashton Kutcher was in one of them.
I mean, I like Ashton Kutcher, but there's a difference between Ashton Kutcher and Ryan Reynolds.
First and foremost, Ryan Reynolds, I'm not into Ryan Reynolds like that, man.
Well, no, I'm just saying, but like, how do you confuse the two? I have not seen it.
No, I know the movie, but I didn't know Ryan Reynolds was in that. Isn't there one with Ashton Kutcher? I got to look this up now because it's going to bug me. Go ahead. Tell us about Just Friends. Ashton
Kutcher? I don't remember.
Okay, we'll talk about Just Friends.
What was that?
I said talk about Just Friends, weirdo, since you want to talk about Just Friends. Ryan Reynolds. Oh, my God.
Oh, no, I was asking if you've ever seen it.
Okay, here's where I got wrong. He was in Just Married with Brittany Murphy.
That's why I was like, wait, what are you talking?
First and foremost, they both have the word just in it. So don't look at me like I'm nuts and I got two heads. And Just Married came out 2 years before Just Friends. Excuse me. Yes. Ryan Reynolds and Anna Faris. Go ahead.
Just Friends was hysterical too. That's another one that I feel like a lot of people have not seen that should watch it because it was good. It's funny.
If I watch it, will you not bug me at 1 o'clock in the morning telling me to watch it?
No, because the other movie was much more important because it was amazing. The other one was just so good. This one's hysterical, but the other one was just, I was in awe watching it. I was like, wow. Every little detail in that film.
First and foremost, I will watch Just Friends because you recommend it. And you've not steered me wrong yet, man. You've not steered me wrong.
I don't. I do not steer wrong when it comes to recommendations.
You don't.
Speaking of like horror films and stuff and how you rather watch Lifetime during this point in time, you sicko. I'm just kidding. I just actually rewatched that movie. What the heck? Oh, my God. Oh, You Better Watch Out.
Yes.
Oh my gosh. I forgot how good that movie is. Because I watched it once. I want to say it was like maybe last year. No, it was like 2-3 years ago I watched that film. And I remembered like bits and pieces because I was like, I'm pretty sure this is what happens. But just rewatching that, I was just like, what the hell?
It's good. It really is. And that's a lot. It's one that a lot of people haven't seen in the 80s. I'm not going to spoil it because I know it's old people, but go out of your way to see it because it really is good. And there's a lot of old school movies like that involve Christmas. Now, I have to ask you, because this has been a debate, a hot topic, if you will, for over the years. Die Hard, Christmas movie or no?
Freaking A, man. I hate this topic because so many people argue about it. There's Christmas lights and it takes place during Christmas time. So people just say it's a Christmas film. Oh, wait, sorry. This is Die Hard. I'm thinking Lethal Weapon for a minute.
What? Sorry. How do you, confuse Die Hard and Lethal Weapon?
See, Ryan Reynolds confused.
Fuck off, man. Yo, you just, He's just confused. Die Hard.
Die Hard is not a Christmas movie. I don't care what anybody says. And it is always a debate with everybody. It's not a Christmas movie. Lethal Weapon, it takes place during Christmas time, so more so Christmas film.
But what if it is around Christmas when it was released? So technically speaking, it could be in Christmas film.
No.
Technicalities. Come on, man. You know about technicalities.
No.
Yes.
It is not like a Christmas movie.
Yep.
I don't believe so. Lethal Weapon, sure. Die Hard, no.
You're very angry when you say that, man. Just the poise.
Die Hard is a Christmas film. It's just, to me, that's not a Christmas movie.
All right. Well, I mean, you and your scrunched up face, I can't see it right now, people. It's over Skype, it's audio, but you probably got a scrunched up face right now while you're saying that. It's okay. I understand. You get a little bowed up, but it's one of those things where, all right, you know, it doesn't have to be a Christmas movie, but fine. But, you know, some people consider it like that. Well, the Chipmunks was great. Chipmunks with Jason Lee and the overall cartoon, and they give the kid the harmonica around Christmas time. Those had some great ones. The harmonica.
I love that one. Like, why don't they play that on TV anymore? it's so good.
Well, Brittany, how come they don't play a lot of Christmas stuff anymore on TV? Why? I don't know. That's true. But the harmonica one was good. They gave Tommy the harmonica in the hospital. They gave him the freaking harmonica, and it was nice, and it was touching. I remember as a kid, I cried because poor Tommy.
And poor Alvin just wanted a hula hoop. Like, poor Alvin.
Okay, stop. The kid had cancer, and he got the harmonica. You want to talk about poor Alvin? That was wrong with you.
I'm saying poor Alvin wanted his hula hoop. No, Tommy thankfully got his, you know, harmonica. That was sweet. It was touching. Yes.
He got the harmonica. People, go out of your way and look up that episode, the Christmas special with Alvin and the Chipmunks, where Tommy gets the harmonica. You'll cry, because it really is a touching moment. You'll cry. Oh. And then you also got Charlie Brown and the Christmas Man.
Oh,
Can't go wrong with Charlie Brown.
No, absolutely not. We have the Christmas tree up in Rockefeller Center right now, actually.
Yo, what's up with that tree, man? That tree looks a little wonky.
A lot wonky.
I'm trying to be nice. I'm trying to be nice. I told you. I sent you the GIF. It's like Charlie Brown with the Christmas tree. And then it goes, man. That's what it is.
No, they made it look better because they filled it. But when they first brought it there, I was like, why would you post this? Like, wait until you fill it. It looks pathetic.
It looks like shit. That's what it looks like. Not even shit, yeah. Brittany Savage. It looks like shit. That's what it looks like. Emphasis on the shit. Say it with me, Brittany Savage. Come on.
Looks like shit.
No, looks like shit.
No, I don't sound like that.
Well, no, I'm saying it like that. So I'm saying you say it. Come on, let it out a little bit. Come on, man. Looks like shit. Go ahead, Brittany.
No.
Why?
Looks like shit.
You know something, Britt? You're no fun. You're no fun, man. You're no fun.
I'm a fun time. It's just, no.
Okay. Can I at least get a buck wild up in this piece?
No, that happens sporadically. Every now and then that'll happen.
Okay, fine.
You can't ask for it. It just happens.
What if I said please? I said the magic word, man. Please.
All right. How about Christmas Day? I will say it for you.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. I'll take that.
All right. You know what I got to say about Christmas Day?
What?
You really can't spell families without lies. Boom. There you go.
Yes. My other favorite film.
As soon as I saw you watching that, I'm like,
when they're in the church. And they're in the church and he's like, you're messing up the line. Then his clap, he just starts clapping during the song.
You people have got to watch that movie. As soon as you put that up, I'm like, oh my god. And we talked about this on the show because I know you love that line so much.
Mm-hmm. I love that movie. Vince Vaughn is an amazing actor.
He really is. Vince
Vaughn, Will Ferrell.
Yeah, people, watch Four Christmases. All right, Four Christmases or Fred Claus? Go.
What was that?
I said Four Christmases or Fred Claus. Which was better?
Oh, Four Christmases, 100%. Fred Claus was, again, I like Vince Vaughn. He's a great actor, but I wasn't that keen on Fred Claus.
Yeah, I'll be honest.
He was the other actor in the film. He was kind of like, eh.
Well, the thing is, too, when I remember watching that, I think it was on, like, Channel 40 or something. I'm like, this is not like what I thought it was going to be. You know what I'm saying? I was a little disappointed.
It definitely was disappointing. I don't know. That whoever that guy was that played Santa kind of creeped me out.
Not like Santa. Yeah. Not 10 a.m. Santa's coming to town.
Santa!
I know him.
Oh, man.
Good. Oh, that was Paul Giamatti who was Santa Claus.
Oh, yep. That's right. No, creepy.
How do you not know Paul Giamatti? Are you just going to put some respect on his name, man?
Oh, whatever. He was creepy.
Is this like you with Daniel Bedingfield? Creepy? Everybody's creepy to you. Why is everybody creepy to you? Why can't they just be normal?
First of all, Daniel Bedingfield is creepy.
Okay.
Second of all, very creepy. Second of all, so is the guy from Five. And I have showed a couple of my friends the guy from Five because we were discussing like boy bands. And Five came up and I was like, oh my God, you have to see this video of when they were in the bowling alley. Look at the dude with the brown leather coat. He is creepy. So creepy. His facial expressions, like, I don't know. Something about him.
Did you tell them that we have this conversation a lot, and as soon as you play the music video, you got to send it to me because, hey, there's the creepy guy bowling again.
Abso-freaking-lutely, man. Absolutely.
Ugh.
He's so strange.
You're also giving me an idea for our part two for when we do our next promo challenge.
Are you going to get a brown leather coat? Are you going to go bowling?
I might. I'm thinking about it. Maybe. Maybe what's your right? well, at least it's not the UK video where they're where like the girl's sitting and she's looking through the thing and then they're all dancing and she's got like getting aroused by it and I'm like, okay, this is not creepy at all. Whatever. Well, if you find it there, all right. Good for you, love. So
oh my gosh. That's so strange.
It is, but you know, still it's you like that song, baby, when the lights go
out. Oh, I love that song. That song is a good song.
Well, the only thing I will say I left out of my promo, I was going to play Together, but this was not the time for Together, so I left a Together part out.
I'm sorry, what?
I said in our last promo I was going to play Together, but the Together part I left out.
Ah, what? Why?
Well, you'll see when we do round two.
Oh, round two. Part two.
So since we're talking about it, and we'll come back to Christmas in a second, you, my good friend, my close friend, because we are close, you know, Mr. Sweet Down to Earth, me over here, even though I tease you to death every day, all day, every day, 24/7, Randy Savage. Yeah. Yes. Well, it's worth it because, you know, you kind of, you know, I hate to say this, man, but I always say it. You're kind of a little bit Stu Nod. So sometimes, you know, you need to be teased a little bit, you know?
Thank you.
You're welcome. But anyway, we just came off Max Wrestling. We just came off Max Wrestling promo series 5, Enemy Lines. And well, you and I tore it down. Great job.
Yes, we did. Yes, of course we did. I mean, more so you than I, which is why we'll have part two. I'm looking forward to it. But yes, you did a very good job in your promo bout against me. So I give you a lot of kudos on that one, Michael.
I give you kudos too, man. Friggin' with the blue skidoo and the 8675309, man. Yeah. And then you just went in depth. Well, the thing is too, you messaged me afterwards and like watching your promo, I think I wanna add a little bit more to mine. Well, again.
Yeah, and I wasn't allowed to. Like, what the fuck was that?
Well, because we had a day, you handed it to me a day late. Well, not day late, I'm sorry, day early, and well, you know, finished product, man.
Finished product, yeah. You were like, I still have part of mine to do. And I was like, well, what the fuck? You get to do yours. You get to add to yours. But nope, I was cut off. I was cut the fuck off.
First and fucking foremost, fucking Savage. Fuck, fuckity, fuck, fuck, fuck. F word over here. So it's just. Well,
That's from a movie. I can't think what movie.
I know. I know it is. By the way, Wedding Crashers was on the other night, and I thought of you because you motorboating son of a bitch, you. And also the fact that Erroneous. And then Mom, the meatloaf.
Mom, the meatloaf.
I wonder what she's doing in there.
Doing.
Classic.
Oh, my God.
Look, aren't they making a sequel? Yes, and they're making a sequel to it. I think they're making a sequel to it.
Oh, my God. It better be the original cast, though. That's all I have to say.
Well, if it's Vince Vaughn and Owen Wilson, absolutely.
Oh, Vince Vaughn is the person who made that film, though. Like, all yes. Shit the bed.
Holy shirts and pants. Holy shirts and
pants. Holy shirts and pants.
Raped in the middle of the night, sock in the mouth.
The midnight rape session. The midnight rape
session. People, you've heard of TLC's Red Light Special, the midnight rape session. Hello.
Do an ass out hug.
Ass out hug.
Oh my God. Okay. Honestly, he like hit all the lines.
He did. That he was great. He was great. And he's like, he's on steroids or something when they're playing football. Yeah. Oh. And he's like, what are you doing? I keep seeing you on your ass. I hate you. It's every line. Every line is great. Putting the friggin' eye drops in his thing and then he's on the toilet. You know what I'm saying? Jesus.
Oh my God. Yeah, that was oh my God, who was that?
Bradley Cooper.
Bradley Cooper, yep.
And Rachel McAdams, I gotta say this, man. Rachel McAdams, whether she's in the Hot Chick, whether she's in this, such a beauty. And Mean Girls, such a cutie beauty. The first time I ever... Yes. Yes, thank you. The first time... Shush. So the first time I saw Rachel McAdams was actually on the famous Jet Jackson. It was actually a very serious episode. She played the sister of the girl who's on the show, Silverstone, that they have on the show, right? So... she plays the sister, and the sister is going through, like, you know, making herself throw up. She's going, you know, she's bulimic the whole nine, and they're actually showing issues of that, which they don't show nowadays, like, with shows and stuff, because, you know, they don't want to go to the extreme. But back in, like, 2000, we got an episode where she's, like, bulimic, and she's making herself throw up, you know? That was one of her first roles.
Yeah, it was one of her first roles.
Mm-hmm. Have you seen this episode, or are you aware of this episode?
I'm pretty sure I've seen it.
All right, I'm just saying, man. I mean, sometimes you're aware, sometimes you're not aware. So I'm just trying to make sure you're on point here, man. I'm trying to make sure you're on point. Do you know what I am saying?
I'm pretty sure I've seen it.
All right. Well, if you haven't, I'll send it to you, nut bar.
Okay. Well, oh, thanks.
You're welcome. So, you're excused. Hey, you had a rough day. You had to take some Mucinex. You're feeling better. That's the main thing. You're nut crazy.
Like I told you, the heat is not working. And that's what I get because yesterday I was like, oh, I'm surprised I'm not sick. I'm surprised I'm good. It's not that I'm sick, but I think it's just because the chill inside of my body from the heat being out, I'm just like, okay, great. Great. So I just like to take stuff if I feel like I might come down with something because I don't want to get sick, but I feel like $100 now. $100, not a million. $100. No, I'm just kidding.
Well, I will say this. First and foremost, Jesus, woman. First and foremost, feeling like $100 over here. I mean, the main thing is that you're feeling better. I know the heat, it sucks. We have had to have our air conditioning fixed. It's not fun. It's not pretty. Coughing out the wazoo. You need some medicine. I took some Dimetapp today because I was feeling like shiznit too. So I'm right there with you. I'm lucky I got through my last shift at work because it was bad. It was bad. I was tossed. I was friggin' dozing, man, because it just was bad. And I was coughing and I was sneezing. Then my dad's looking at me like, why are you coughing? I'm like, I don't have the coronavirus. We've had this test. I came back negative, Dad. I haven't left the house. I've been working from home, Daddy-O. I'm like, I don't have the coronavirus. I'm like, I'm coughing, all right? Allergies. It happens. Not everything is the coronavirus, okay? We don't need to quarantine our asses, Daddy-O. Good Lord, man. Why are you coughing? Because I'm coughing, all right? Hey, leave me alone. People can cough.
That's Rona. Everybody has the Rona automatically. I'm like, no! I just coughed. Gosh.
Gosh, give me some of your tots. So,
I feel bad for anybody who's gone through that, you know, but
yeah, of course, me too.
Just because you cough doesn't insinuate that you have the freaking virus, man. Like, back up.
Freaking keep back up, back up. Tell me what you want to do now. Keep rolling, 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 rolling. What? Yeah. All right. Now, we get back into more Christmas because this is what happens. We just go off, and I love each and every second of this. Pretty savage. Yeah,
jump around.
Jump up to get down. Good Lord. Okay. All right, House of Pain, pack it up, pack it in. Let me begin. I came to win. Battle me. That's a sin. Yes. So, okay. Back to the promo for a second here. So we had a lot of realism. We had a lot of genuineness, if you will, genuine vibes in the promo, which I enjoyed. I think you did a great job just talking about me and, you know, but, you know, making fun of my top hat. But I will say this.
Bro.
Seth?
That's a way to put yourself over, bro.
I'm not done yet, Mel. I got to put myself over because, duh.
Joe.
Oh, hey, man. I kind of have to put myself over. Do I have to go back to Glam Slam 1-2-3? Because I covered that in my promo. Glam Slam 1-2-3.
Oh, my God. I died.
You died?
No. I mean, laughing.
Oh, died. Okay. Why? Because I introduced you as you're more orange than a Nickelodeon logo and then you're more orange than an Oompa Loompa?
Died. I was like, wow. Burn.
Well, how can I not? Well, here's the thing. It's the nuances. How can I not do that when November is the 11-year anniversary of you wrestling on SmackDown? It ties in.
A month ago. Mm-hmm.
Yes. And we had this discussion earlier today because we were talking about when we attended some WWE events where you saw me as an 11-year-old cheering for Triple H and Kane at Madison Square Garden. You know what I'm saying? And then I see you dancing to Shawn Michaels' Sexy Boy at Royal Rumble 08 at Madison Square Garden. You go, girl. So, I mean, it's one of those things where we reflect on our memories. Ain't that right, Savage?
Oh, of course. Memories.
Yes. Well, look at it like that. You were dancing to Shawn Michaels. Sexy boy. Sexy boy. And then a year later, you're wrestling Beth Phoenix on SmackDown.
Huh? I said I'm not your boy.
So, but look at it like that, man. 2008, you're in the crowd. And then 2009, you're wrestling on SmackDown. Hello.
I know, right? It all comes full circle. I'm pretty sure I had just started or I was getting ready to start with my wrestling training during that period of time. Because I started in 2008. Yes. I forget what month that Royal Rumble was, but I know I started in training January of 2008.
That was January of 2008.
Okay, so yeah, it might have been like right when I was getting ready to start with training. And then, yeah, that's funny because a year later, I ended up not there, obviously, because that was what MSG. I was at Dunkin' Donuts Arena.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you were. Yeah,
full circle, man. Who would have thought me dancing to Shawn Michaels would bring me into a WWE wrestling ring? Just kidding.
So
they were like, yeah, that girl. We're going to bring her back next year.
Friggin' watching you in the crowd. That girl's dancing to Sexy Boy. Put her against Beth Phoenix. That's what that is. Okay, so the Royal Rumble in 08, which is one of the most iconic Rumbles with John Cena returning and winning. January 27, 2008, Brittany Savage.
Okay, yeah, so I just started wrestling then. I was wrestling already.
Yep. And you showed your fandom with that dance. You were getting down, man. Hello.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You got to start as a fan if you want to wrestle, right?
Yeah, that's true. That is true. That's very true.
Sometimes you got to do a little dance, too.
Hey, man, we'll talk about my dance moves in a second here because they were on fire. But before we get to that, yo, but then I showed you me just cheering as an 11-year-old with my red shirt and my blonde hair, man. You know, hey, this is before the glasses.
Yeah, I can tell.
Yes. I mean, you were laughing at me. Why are you laughing at me? Because I was throwing my arms up in the air, man. You're laughing at me.
That's honestly exactly why, because I was looking at the video and I was like, I think that's Michael, but I'm not quite sure if that's Michael. And then the hands go up in the air and I was like, that's definitely Michael.
I was 11.
I was like, without a doubt. I was 11. People don't forget.
True. It was like 8 years ago, asshole. But no, I had fun. Like, it was a good time. It was myself. My mom was next to me. Our family friend, Carl. It was a good time, man. It was a good time. Third row. Here's the thing. Going to that event, coming home from fifth grade, yo, I had no idea that we were going to be that close. And we were. And I'm like, oh, shit, I'm going to be on camera.
Yeah, it's a great time when you're a fan. It's awesome.
That's true. But also, you're now calling me a mark because I was throwing my hands up in the air. Is that the antithesis of our friendship, man? You're just going to call me a mark right here, right now, Jesus Jones?
No, it's just because every time that we do a podcast together, you're always throwing something. So, of course, you're going to throw your hands up because there were no props or anything next to you to throw.
Well, first and first and foremost, I had to throw my mic down because do I look like a fucking prop to you, Brittany Savage? I'm a man. And this man is telling you that you suck. I don't know where that came from. I'll be honest with you. That was just in the moment. I knew what I was going to do with the, well, you were cracking up once I start doing that. All he does is talk, 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 talk. Why won't he shut up? My God.
I mean, I don't sound like that, though.
You kind of do.
I really don't, though.
Absolutely.
Definitely not.
Yep. The Nile's not just a river in Egypt. The Nile's just not a river in Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
Woman. Well, did you also like the fact that I said boom, 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 podcasting in my room?
Oh, my gosh. I was dying.
How many parts of this promo did you laugh at?
A lot. I laughed at a decent amount.
You got it.
Honestly. That's why I was like, oh, damn, I should probably redo this right now. And you were like, no, it's already done.
It's already done. Like,
oh, well, why the fuck do you have a second shot? That's fine.
I didn't have a second shot. I was already done. Well,
oh,
first,
you're just adding more to your hour movie over here.
First and foremost, I said it was half pop culture, half seriousness. And that was what you got. You got 20 minutes of first 10, half pop culture, second half seriousness. And when I said, I just dropped the, I just dropped that bomb, 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 bomb on that ass.
Literally, it was like a short fucking film.
But it was good.
It was good. It was funny. I thought it was funny.
Well, what'd you think about
it? Let me just add some more. And you're just like, no. Cool.
So, well, we had to hand it in. So I'm just like, what you have is fine. It's good. Just leave it alone.
Yeah, leave it alone. He's like, but, you know, I'm just going to add a couple more things to mine. Then I'll be all set. And I'm like, okay.
First of all, you have this whole thing incorrect. I never said I'm just going to add more stuff. I was already done.
No, I think you had to add like one more little thing to it.
Well, yeah, the last part I had to do was the dance, man, where I forget the choreography with my Millennium Backstreet Boys t-shirt on, doing Tell Me Why, and here's a little choreography. Oh, and here's me just, you know, doing Bye 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 like when I was 7 or 8 years old, but this one goes, how come I've never seen these films? I'm like, I got to find them. You'll be the first to know when I find them so you can watch me dancing in my bathroom to Bye 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 because you want to laugh your head off. This is why. That's because you do. All right. So. And I did a better Carlton dance than you. You know that. You know this is true.
That's all you talk about.
It was. Well, you read. What do you mean that's all I talk about? I don't know what that Carlton was, okay. Man.
First of all, I have the moves that kill. Like, my moves are like Jagger's.
Bullshit. Okay? Bullshit.
They are sweet. Sweet. The best moves you'll ever see.
Bullshit.
I can floss like a boss.
Floss like a boss. I got to see that cha-cha, man, you know? Well, this is another thing, man, because we kept talking about when I come to New York, whatever, man. I got to see that cha-cha. Now I got to find some place to dance since you got sick moves. I'll out-dance you in public, man. You don't want none. You don't want none of this. You really don't.
Destiny's Child. You don't think I can handle this jelly? What?
I didn't say that. I said, I said, you don't want none. You don't want none, man. I didn't say, I don't think you're ready for this jelly. I ain't talking about bootylicious, woman.
I can definitely take you. And don't think I did not notice your downward dab, which, by the way, was not good.
Yes, it was.
Mine's a lot better, though.
No, it's not. I don't even know what the hell that downward dab was. I saw you.
Anyway.
You did the downward dab in that. Mine actually was a dab. I don't even know what that was. That just looked ridiculous. It looked like you were just putting your head to your thing. Maybe you were trying to wipe off the sweat, man, because you were sweating because you knew this promo was going to be on fire. Wiping off the sweat?
I'm just blinking my eyes extremely fast right now.
Why?
Because you're... No. It was not... No, I was not sweating. That is the best downward dab that anybody can do besides Miss Betty White herself.
Stop. So okay, good. First and foremost, you are not comparing yourself to the legendary Miss Betty White, who's still kicking butt in her 90s, man.
I'm saying I can do it just as good.
What was that? What? Stop it.
My downward dab is so good. You're just jealous.
Mine was an actual dab. I did do the dab correctly, man. That was good. It was good.
That's like the usual dab that people do.
What the fuck is the difference? It's a dab.
Because it's like the teenager dab. You have to be down with, like, you know, the older crew with a downward dab.
First of all, Betty White, just because Betty White, who's in her 90s, did a downward dab and you thought it was the greatest thing ever, doesn't mean that you're a connoisseur of the goddamn downward dab.
The downward dab is the best.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
Don't worry. I'll teach you my cool downward dab moves. Between that and my floss and what's the other moves? Oh, my Carlton? Yes.
Yeah. And the cha-cha. Apparently you could cha-cha because I'm... All right. The only reason I'm interested in this is because my mom, back in the day, actually did her thing in Arthur Murray, ballroom dancing. I like that stuff. So now I got to learn the cha-cha. You like a do the cha-cha. You're like Bruce Almighty. I like a do the cha-cha.
It's all about the hips. Hips don't lie. You got to use those hips, Shakira.
First and foremost, I use those hips in my Napoleon Dynamite dance. I did a little wiggle. You know what I'm saying? At the end of that, because I was...
I saw that. Yeah. No, you did. However...
Yes.
You got to use those hips for a cha-cha.
I think I'm okay in that department.
Like, you gotta like really move them.
I can move my hips. Are you trying to say that I'm broken with my hips? I got nothing.
I'm not saying you're broken. I'm just saying they gotta move more.
I can move my hips. Whatever, hater.
You should practice them like wearing high heels though.
I'm not putting on high heels. Shut up. All right. Enough of this conversation. No. Stop with the high heels. That's where I draw the line. Stop it. This is not chick like me. It's not chick like me. Shut up. So.
No, I'm just messing with you. But you do have to like move your hips a lot more for the cha-cha.
I'm just saying. I'm willing to learn. I'm right here, man. I'm willing to learn. Fool.
In the South Carolinas.
At least you got it right this time, friggin' North Carolina. Come on, raise up. Dummy.
Whatever. It's still the Carolinas. North, south.
Be quiet. Just be quiet. Just no. Just shush. 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 Just shush, woman. Shush. But no, the Napoleon Dynamite thing, even though I didn't do the role, it was not bad. It was not bad. Vote for Pedro. I still vote for Pedro. Yes. And then I ran to my room, which was hilarious. And I was pretty much exhausted after that because I was exhausted. just because I'm like, God, how does he do it?
You down a lot.
I did. I did. Yes, I did run a lot. I did.
You?
I did run a lot, yeah.
No, you did. You sang a lot.
I ran a lot.
Spoke a lot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Again, short film.
But no, I think we both told a great story, even though mine... Well, here's the thing. You were laughing at the fact that... Okay, there's one other part that I did. I made fun of you with your Greg impression from Summer Jam, and I was eating a sugar cookie because hence Sugar Rush.
I know. Yep.
Then here's the one that really got you. I poured the water on my head.
The water. Fucking water on your head. I died because it wasn't it killed me because you didn't just pour the water on your head, you dumped water on your head and I just lost it.
I was like, oh my God. Then I made the face like the boy band's doing the sexy like
freaking Nick Carter, yeah.
I'm like, I know, she'll get this and she'll laugh. And I was right.
Oh, I was hysterical. Because I was like expecting you to like just pour the water, like, you know, like hold the cup like extremely high above your head and like pour the water. No, you held it like close to your head and just fucking dumped it. Like you were on that Nickelodeon show with the slime.
Figure it out. It's called yeah. Figure it out.
Oh. It's literally when all I can think of, I was like, oh my God, Michael. I was like, he's gonna get sick. And then the friggin' head back and forth, I can't.
Wait, what are you talking about? The what back and forth? What are you talking about?
Head with you know, the Nick Carter, like, boy band type look.
Oh, the slow motion.
Playing.
The slow motion.
With the hair.
And I put my finger on my lip.
I like, go back and rewatch that, honestly, because it makes me laugh. It makes me laugh.
It's all right. A lot of our peers really enjoyed it. I'm not going to lie. I showed it to our good friends, Miss Black Rose, Nikki Adams, and the cutie pie, Miss Candy Cartwright herself. And Candy told me that I totes won, and she said that was very entertaining. So I totes won. Thank you, Candy. I appreciate that. See, she can't cutie pie Candy Cartwright knows.
For sure.
And Nikki Adams, who you got, you know, Tennessee. We'll go back to that.
What happened about Tennessee? Listen,
you in Tennessee, man. You and your pizza and your tap water.
Listen, that was a bad time. Such a bad time.
Yeah, but still, it makes for good times and somewhat memories, if you will. Somewhat, maybe not good memories, but memories.
I'd say, speaking of, I saw, I think Nikki actually went back to wrestling.
I did, which much love to Nikki Adams.
I'm going to find out. I'm going to have to message her and ask her about it.
Please do, because I'll be honest, she's awesome. Yes, Miss Nikki Adams. Whew. Okay, going back to Christmas, because this is what this is. All right, we'll go back to some of my favorite things with Christmas. So Christmas gifts, I remember as a kid, I got Good Burger, and I wasn't expecting it. Obviously, you know, you get clothes from your grandparents, and also I just love getting DVDs, video games. I'll be honest with you, being the wrestling fan, when you got your I was that kid. When you got the video games for Christmas, right? I don't play them as much now because, well, I'm a grown-ass man, and I've gotten older, so I've kind of lost out of the video game stuff. With
video games.
What's sorry.
That? What? Didn't mean to cut you off, but there's nothing wrong with playing video games.
There is nothing wrong with it, but I'm just saying, okay. As I've gotten older, I'm not as into it as much. I play them, but time from time. It's not like religiously is what I'm saying.
Okay. I was going to say, because I love playing video games.
I love video games too, but I'm saying you do realize, like, when you have, hold on, man, woman, with your work ethic, freaking, you know that it's tough. Yes, with freaking work and priorities, you don't play video games as much. That's what I'm saying. It's not like I hate video games; it's just I don't play them as much as I used to.
All right. I'm just making sure.
I love video games. I still have all the WWE games. I got Gran Turismo. I got the NBA shootouts. I got a lot of video games. I got the Grand Theft Autos. I'm all up in that. I got Def Jam Vendetta. It's a good time.
GTA.
Yes.
GTA was such a fun game. I have no idea still to this day how to play that game. I would just GTA, Grand Theft Auto.
I know. Which one, though? There's two. There's Vice City. There's San Andreas. What are you talking about?
Wait, which one? The city? Which one was that?
Vice City?
Vice City, yeah. Sorry. So Vice City is the one that I used to play when I was younger. And I just remember I used to just rip people out of their car, beat them up, steal the car, drive around, beat up hookers, and then just drive into buildings. And I had no idea what I was doing.
That's really the synopsis. Well, that's the synopsis of Grand Theft Auto in a nutshell. That's
is
what
that
it is.
How you're supposed to play? Because I really didn't think that there was like a point or a plot to this game. Well, I was like, yeah.
Yeah, so the only plot of Grand Theft Auto is just to go. There is a plot, but it's mostly you're just going around killing people and shooting at shit, picking up hookers.
Okay, all right. That's what I. Okay, so I was on to something.
You were doing something. I don't know what it was, but you're doing something. But no, like, and my mom will tell you every time I got a wrestling video game for Christmas, you would not see me for the rest of the night because that's what it was because you're excited. But yeah, no, I'll be honest with you. I can't even do the wrestling games now because once you got to like the 2Ks and stuff, it's, and I think a lot of people can attest with me with wrestling video games, the nostalgia is great because we all love nostalgia, like you with your Grand Theft Auto, and I'll catch myself sometimes putting in Who Wants to Be a Millionaire for the PS1 and Wheel of Fortune. Like, I'd rather play those than friggin', you know, a lot of the games that are out now, you know? So I'm very nostalgic with it. How about yourself?
Yeah, I mean, like you said, like with work and everything, I don't have as much time, but Brooke loves playing video games now too, which is amazing. I love it. So once I have actually vacation time coming up in 2 weeks, so her and I are going to spend a decent amount of time playing video games just because I haven't been able to. So we play a lot of like horror games, like scary games, and then Mortal Kombat. I sound like such a horrible mom by saying tangle this. But, you know, she plays, like, her kid games, too. And then we play Five Nights at Freddy, a.k.a. I play it because she gets kind of scared. And then a lot of, like, Resident Evil is involved. So, yeah, we play stuff like that. It's fun.
First of all, great games, number one. Great games. Number two, of course it's horror-related. Of course it is.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of the name of this game. Oh, my gosh. I don't remember the name of it. No, I don't remember. Freaking A. I don't remember the name of it. But she broke out of it for me for my birthday. And it has, like, Jason in it. It has Ghostface. It has a whole bunch of these horror villains in the game. And it even has... the Demi Gordon from Stranger Things in it.
Yeah, buddy.
Cool. What was that? Oh, Dead by Daylight.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
It's a really good game. I have not yet unlocked Ghostface, which obviously he's my favorite. So gotta try to unlock him.
I'm still laughing just because you have a young daughter and you got all these horror games. It's great.
She bought it for me for Christmas.
What?
Not Christmas, sorry, my birthday.
That's awesome. See, I can appreciate that, though. That's awesome.
Yeah, so, I mean, we have fun with it. Like, it's a good time.
That's why she's the mini.
It's just a game.
It's just a game. Oh. It starts out as a game, but then reality sets in, man.
My daughter's not like a Michael Myers or anything like that, or a Chucky.
Well, first and foremost, you have all these dreams about this crap, and you're like ready to kill a bitch any moment, man. You're ready to scrap. So, I mean, come on. I'm just saying. Sometimes you want to choke some people, and I know you, because your temper gets to like a level 10 sometimes. So it is what it is. You're not afraid to pop off.
I'm gonna get to a level 10. It depends on, you know.
I get to a level 10, and she answers me.
It doesn't. My dreams get very intense, though. Dreams about drug guys breaking into my job. Like, what the hell is that? I have no idea.
It's ridiculous. You're ridiculous.
I'm just saying. And then, oh my God, did I tell you? Sorry, off topic. But after, okay, remember my scary dream that I had? My nightmare, if you will?
Yes.
Okay. So did I tell you that my friends and I, we were at work and we're just talking. And then, like, when you open the front door, this, like, ding goes off for the bell. And if you open the back door, it does that too. So the noise went off and nobody came through the front. This guy who was bringing the shipment came through the back and, like, didn't knock or anything, just freaking straight up opened the back door and was like, hello. Like, my nightmare was coming true. It was so creepy.
What the fuck?
Yeah. I was like,
Oh, I think also Christmas, I know we're bouncing around because this is what we do, but Christmas-wise, I will say this. One thing I didn't mention, because we mentioned, like, the classics. Like, we love the classics. There's Christmas Story. There's everything that's really encompassed with Christmas and the Christmas carols. But I'm going to say this right now, since we're also, this kind of ties into the horror effect. Like, Jack Frost, Michael Keaton Jack Frost, Kelly Preston Jack Frost. Okay.
Michael Keaton Jack Frost. The horror Jack Frost, so bad.
Yes. I had this conversation with, you know, Case in there and him and his Pam's Ice Cream. Support your local businesses. I live around the block from them. Thank you. Thank you, Case. And we know. So anyway, he's going to kill me again. But it's one of those things where I look at it from a stance of, I've seen both of them. I've seen the mutant snowman. I remember it as a kid. It's funny because, like, late night, it was like, oh my God, it was on TNN. Before it was like Spike TV and, you know, all these different channels now and whatever. When it was TNN, right? So it was like 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, and I didn't have school, so I saw Jack Frost 2, and I'm like, they made a sequel to the one with Michael Keaton? I'm like, no, it's completely different. And I'm like, it sucks. I've seen both of them. And somebody uploaded Jack Frost 2 onto YouTube, which, why the hell would you do that? But okay, if that makes you happy. It's cheesy. It's horrible. The snow babies and these killing them with icicles and shit. But the Michael Keaton one with Kelly Preston is good. You know what I'm saying? It has that little, it's a nice little thing. You know, his father dies. Unfortunately, he comes back as the snowman. And it has a cute premise to it, you know?
It definitely does. I love that film. It was so sad, though. So extremely sad. But it is
a car wreck. It's a car wreck. The guy's in the car wreck. And I'm like, I feel so bad. Oh. And then he comes back as the snowman to help the kid. See, that there's something into that, man. That's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. No, it definitely was. I love that movie. It was another good one.
Well, they also, we had Prancer, which was one, and then they did a Prancer Returns. Yeah. Have you ever seen the Prancer? Yeah. Yeah.
The original Santa Claus that you were talking about, not the one with Tim Allen, which was good, but the other one, like the original, like the old school one.
From the 80s, yeah, Santa Claus the movie.
Yes, I love that one. I have it on DVD, actually.
We have that on VHS, back from back in the day,
Yeah. Well, I ended up buying it on DVD just because I remember I loved that movie. Growing up, I was like, this movie is so good.
It really is. And people really need to go back and watch that one, too, because I remember when I first, you know what it was? It was around Christmas time and we hadn't watched this particular film because I've never seen it before. And then I watched it with my grandparents and I'm like, you know what? This was actually really good. And it was. It's funny, but it also has a nice, very premise, great premise to it. I think that was around the time when Miracle on 34th Street came out and all those, too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was like more realistic. You know what I'm saying? Like the old school like Christmas movies were more realistic than the new Christmas films.
Absolutely. 100% concur with you on that one, Miss Brittany Savage. But yes.
Like, Santa's actually looked like Santa's. They didn't look all like jacked up looking and fake as hell. Like they looked like actual Santa Claus.
Hey, I mean, we had Jingle All the Way with Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Great movie.
I love Jingle All the Way. It's
funny. So many people hate that movie, but I love it.
It's okay. People will think it's bad, but it is. It's funny. It's funny bad because it's just every line is funny. And Arnold Schwarzenegger trying to get the toy for his kid is hilarious. Arnold.
Absolutely.
Yes.
In the end, when he dresses up and he goes, Jamie.
Yes. Yes. First of all, don't see Jingle All the Way 2 because that one was horrible. That was the one with Santino Marella from WWE and Larry the Cable Guy. Fuck that one.
Yeah, my mom had that on earlier. She was watching it. She was talking about that. Really? But I didn't watch it.
Oh, it was horrible. It's horrible. It's just, no. That was the one Christmas movie I can't get down with. I know Miz did the Christmas movie that he did.
Oh, with Paige?
Yeah, there was one of them. What was it? It was Christmas something. That's going to bug me because I can't.
The name of that one, but that one was actually cute. That wasn't bad.
It was, but I'm just saying, I remember Miz did a Christmas movie for WWE. Oh, Christmas Bounty. Christmas Bounty.
Oh, right. Yep. You're right. There's, sorry, go ahead.
No, I was saying that was not bad, man. Why are you interrupting me? You're just going to cut me off. You're going to put me out. Beast of Burden. You've heard of the Rolling Stones. You've heard of Papa was a Rolling Stone. Scratch that. Savage was a Rolling Stone. Go, Britt.
Always. I'm the worst. No, I've been trying to actually look it up on my phone. I don't remember where I watched it. If it was like Netflix or Hulu. Oh my God, I can't remember the girl's name. Freaking A, man. The girl who was in Scream Queens, the blonde girl. What's her name?
The girl from Scream Queens that was in the Christmas Bounty?
No. I'm trying to talk about like a different movie because I wanted to see if you saw it. Okay. But I can't remember her name.
Oh my God, the girl from Scream Queens. That's going to bug me too now. Hold on. The American comedy series, Scream Queens.
Yeah. With Jamie Lee Curtis. Oh, Emma my God. Roberts. Huh?
Emma Roberts?
Yes, Emma Roberts. Thank you.
She was an Unfabulous on Nickelodeon, and she was in friggin' We're the Millers.
Yeah, I know. She's in a bunch of crap, like American Horror Story and Nerve. But there's a movie that just came out called Holiday. It's a 2020 film. I don't know if you saw it, but it was actually really good. I enjoyed it, at least.
Okay. Yes, I actually am aware of this because this goes back to the bald-headed one that is named Kaysen. Hi, buddy. Anyway, I feel bad, and I love that man, but I gotta tease him. Because he sees, you know what the thing is, too? He just won't admit it to you because he doesn't want you to get mad at you, but I'll say it, like, I'll call it like it is. I am not watching Holiday because you were promoting that on your Facebook, and I'm like, are you serious right now? Holiday with Emma Roberts? There's some things that I gotta say to you, man. No. You know what I'm saying? Just no. Sometimes I got to pull it back and hit break. No. Okay, tell us about Holiday since it was so great, Brittany. Or are you just saying that, Brittany?
No. Wait, are you insinuating you don't like anything with Emma Roberts, or was that Kaysen?
No, that was... that was
is that what I heard from this, or no? That's not what I heard? Not what I got out of this?
First and foremost, no. When I had him on the mic with Mike, I just said... Kaysen, it's very easy. Just say Brittany automatically assumes things and that she's wrong most of the time. It's okay. You can admit. So,
yeah.
I incriminate. Yes, absolutely. So no, but he commented on that because I was laughing. And I'm like, dude, yes, I know, because Brittany will say this is great because it's holiday and has to do with that. But you were raging about this movie. And I'm like, is it really that good? Or are you just saying this because, you know, you and you got to watch all these new movies and everything, got to be on top of everything.
Well, yeah, and I'm not just saying that it was great. Gosh. I actually enjoyed it. I thought it was very cute. So it's about this girl, and she has terrible luck when it comes to finding romance. And it was Christmas time one year, and her youngest brother ended up getting engaged. And she's the last one who still hasn't gotten married, doesn't even have a boyfriend, blah, 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 blah. And then she goes to the mall. And at the mall, she's trying to return a pair of pants that her brother got for her for Christmas, pajama pants that were extremely large. So she tried to return those. And then he was having bad luck with this girl he was dating. She was basically crazy. And then he was in line in front of Emma Roberts. And they kind of bickered like back and forth briefly. And she mentioned about a holidate because her aunt had something called a holidate, which you don't have to settle down with this person. You guys just go out every holiday and have each other as a date. So that way your parents don't ask questions and you're never alone. So that's how it started off. And obviously it's going to end with a happy ending, but it was good. It was good. I liked it.
All right. I might check this out.
Background, because I don't want to spill anything and ruin anything, but it was cute.
I might have to check this out, man. I'll think about it, especially since you said, there's a happy ending at the end. I understand. Okay. Happy ending at the end. Cool.
Emma Roberts is pretty funny. So she has a lot of really good lines in there that'll make you laugh.
But you said there's a happy ending at the end, so I expect the happy ending at the end.
Oh, yeah, of course. Of course.
You set yourself up for that, man. You set yourself up for that with your innuendos there.
I always set myself up.
What? God. Okay. Well, I will say this, by the way. There's other they're speaking of movies. By the way, I would like to say in your face, because two girls that watched our promo, and there's a couple girls that actually like Jennifer's body, so shut up. Because you said no female would like Jennifer's body. And there are some females that watched my promo and your promo that like Jennifer's body. So, and
movie's terrible. Like, I'm just going to throw it out there.
Well, you said
rash.
You said no female likes that movie. And I proved you wrong. Because, you see, you got to make, again, the automatic assumptions that, you know, people don't watch certain movies. And I know they weren't talking about I Know Who Killed Me, because nobody knows what the fuck that is. But you know what Jennifer's body is. If you want to watch somebody with a leg and, you know, and then with the leg bullshit, charging, I mean, that's their leg. Charging the leg or a succubus in your body. I mean, what would you take? I'll take the succubus. Succubus.
Oh, my God. I'm saying Jennifer's body is not good, though. Like,
I'm not saying it's the greatest movie in the world, but you're acting like people don't watch it. You know what I'm saying? That's what you're saying. You're just saying no.
I'm not saying people don't watch it. Maybe they felt bad for you, so they just wanted to pretend.
First and foremost, enough. How about you know that they? How about they actually like it? And first and foremost, as someone who does surveys here, you just gonna put out surveys over here, man? Someone who works in the market research film, you just gonna take over my jab and just say shit like that, man?
I should put up a survey and see how many people actually like the film Jennifer's Body without the scene, without the makeout scene.
Oh, it's a great scene, though, man. Passionate.
Okay. Take away the scene. Do you like the film? Oh, sorry. Take away that scene and then the end scene when she gets stabbed in the boob. Do you like that movie?
I plead the fifth.
Oh, and the 8675309 that you love so much.
It's
take three okay. out.
So all right. Probably how not. Do you not incorporate that? It's her name is Jenny and it's a classic song. How do you not incorporate that? That was brilliant. Brilliant. Well, they're killing her.
I'm just saying, as a fan of the OC growing up and liking Adam Brody, not a good film. Even Scream 4, Adam Brody was in it. Horrible. I love Scream films.
I went to that with my buddy to see Scream 4. And I'll be honest, disappointed.
So bad. So bad.
So, yes, I agree with you on the Scream 4 because I did see that in the theaters. But, okay, first and foremost, I did not watch that trash that was the OC. Stop that, all right? You and the OC over here. I'm a guy. I don't watch the OC.
You've never seen the OC?
I didn't want to watch the OC.
It wasn't a bad show. It was pretty good.
All right. You see, here's the thing, too. You make me feel bad because you're like, oh, that's not a bad show. Would you like to give it a try? What? Hey, man.
I don't talk like that.
You do. A little way like that. I'm just waiting for you to, like, pout your eyes and shit. Like, would you please watch it? You know who you're like? You're like the kid from Ned's Declassified School Survivor. You're like little Martin where he has that sad face and you just, you know, the eyes and shit, man. They make you want to do stuff and then you feel bad. You make me feel bad for dissing you. You know what it is? That's what it is. You got the puppy dog eyes.
Good. Because you shouldn't diss me. I'm a nice person.
I know you are. We discussed this. We talked about how close we were in the promo. People know now, woman. So, yes, people can sense that. Also, by the way, you're not just going to ignore my favorite line, man, of that promo.
Which one?
It's apropos that your initials are BS because everything you say is bullshit. Come on, you know that was good.
It was funny, okay? It's not something I've never heard before my entire life growing up. Well, wow, all your initials spell curse words. Okay.
First off, hold on there, man. Hold on. Nobody in the amount of time that we've done the promos in the promo league who's faced you, nobody has put that line together except for me because I'm observant. Unlike you are very observant. I notice everything. Britney Savage. Correct.
Hey, it's about time somebody else does. I'm very observant. You have to be observant. You have to study how a person is.
Also, I also got to thank you because out of every one of your opponents, you gave me more time than all your other opponents.
I did. But I think the second one, there will definitely be more time. I'm not going to say it's going to be a short film like yours. But honestly, I think how long was mine? Like 20 minutes? That's a lot for me. I usually go 2.
Wait a minute. Hold on. I went 20 minutes. You went 5 minutes. In total, our promos together were 25 minutes.
Oh, okay. Sorry. It felt like fucking eternity, my promo. I was like, wow, it was very long. Because me, it's like usually like under 60 seconds to like a minute, 2 minutes tops. And that's it.
Hey, I told Chef to shut up because he thought you murdered me. And I'm like, she killed you in 48 seconds. Shut up, Chef. Shut up. Stop.
No, it was not the greatest on my end. That's why I give you kudos because it was good.
I'm not just putting myself over, I'm putting you over too because a lot of people really like
yeah, what, right.
What do you mean, yeah, right? You were good. You were good. That was one of my favorite promos because it told a great story. And I love going against Nico and putting on the face paint, but this was one of my favorites. Oh. I did the downward dab for you. I poured water on my head. Good Lord, woman. What else do you want?
You didn't pour water. You dumped water.
I knew it was coming. As soon as I just said sweatier than a Backstreet Boys music video, I'm like, oh, here it comes. And I'm like, yes, I get to pour water on my head. Dude, I filled that up, and then I just went, quit playing games with my heart.
Oh, yeah. The head back and forth, like, woo.
But no, yeah, I think what I liked about yours is the Blue Skidoo made me laugh. The 8675 made me laugh. And also, because you're just like, I've been through a lot in wrestling. And also, your face was very scrunched up. I'm like, oh, there's that scrunched up face again. And, you know, you're getting very...
I noticed I do that face. I guess I do that face a lot, though, because I actually came across a wrestling photo, like an old wrestling photo of me just standing there with that face. And I'm like, I do this a lot. And it could be like... You know, might not be a good thing all the time, but it's just my facial expression.
I was just like, oh, that's cute. Her little face is scrunched up. She's getting intense. This is what I've done in wrestling. I'm like, oh, look at her. Her face is all scrunched. Scrunched.
Thank you.
No, it was good, though. Like, you were very intense about talking about wrestling and what you've done and the whole night. Oh, it was encompassed a lot. You want to talk about, oh, I didn't put enough into it. It was good. Shut up. I wanted to smack you when you said that. I did. I virtually smacked you via text because it was ridiculous.
I smacked you. I can't.
Or I just pat you on. Or what I do is if when I see you when I'm in New York, you know what I'm going to do? I'm not even going to slap you. You know what I do? You want to know what I do, Brittany Savage?
What?
I'd pat you on the head because you're a little munchkin. Booyah. So,
always so insulting. You call me munchkin. I'm, what am I? An Oompa Loompa.
First of all, you even got it wrong. You said I never called you the Pillsbury Dough Girl. What the fuck?
You, okay. Okay. Wait. You may not have called me an Oompa Loompa, but you called me the Nickelodeon blimp. Okay.
First of all, I said it was a blimp. I never called you a blimp. I said, and I quote verbatim, woman, once again, woman, I said you were more orange than a Nickelodeon logo. I didn't say you were the blimp.
Well, the logo is pretty much kind of like the blimp. Or, okay, the logo is fat still too, though.
The logo is orange, and you were tanned and orange, and I said you look like a Jersey Shore reject. Get your fist pumping in the air, which actually ties back into wrestling because that was Robbie E's theme song in TNA. Get your fist pumping in the air with your girl, the one and only Cookie, a.k.a. Becky Bayless.
Yes. Yes. So? I think, actually, somebody made me come out to that song once at a wrestling show, and I was like, why am I coming out to
get Robbie? Get your fist pumping in the air. Yep, yep.
I tried fist pumping on my way out to the wrestling ring when that music came
good.
On.
And I was like, <Wasn't good. laughs> looking like a jerk. Well, I had to do it. Well, here's the thing. A lot of people thought that was a nice touch because I'm like looking like a Jersey Shore reject from Long Island, New York. Brittany Carter.
Yeah. Jerk.
And then I made Beth Phoenix is all nice. She's a future WWE.
Yeah. Yep. You sure did. I was like, wow.
I made bets all nice. Then I commentated the match. Your referee for the evening is Mr. Justin King. And it was Mr. Justin King.
Yeah, he, what do you call it? I saw him one night when I was living in Tampa. I was out to eat and then he was there. And I was like, oh, remember the time how you made me get up, get back down, get up, get back down? It wasn't him. It was McMahon in his ear. But I was like, that was fun.
Justin King, yes. He was actually not a bad referee, though. I can't. Not Justin King. I like Justin King. But, yeah. Get you up, back down. What, I'm guessing you got a little tension with Justin King? What the hell did Justin King ever do to you? Besides?
Oh, no, not at all. He was a great guy. No, it was a joke because all refs have to wear that earpiece.
I know. So we all know that the word earpiece, man.
Okay, so I was in the ring, right? And I was trying to get up. He's like, all right, get up slowly. All right, get back down. Get up slowly. I was like, I look like a freaking idiot right now. Like,
well,
get up, get back down, get up. What the frig?
I pick things up, I put them down. Nope. Saturday Night Live. I pick things up, put them down.
Yes. Sorry, it took me a second.
Way to go, woman. This is gonna be a new thing now, woman.
Woman.
No, but I. You know what's funny about it, too? You forgot the other part.
Which part?
Freaking, that girl was on the way down like Ryan Cabrera.
Oh, who can forget that?
That I played on the way down.
I can't with you.
Hey, man. I was really having a lot of fun with this. You know what it was, too? And I got to give him credit. Kenny Killa, who was one of our mentors as far as podcasting goes. Such a great guy. He's from the UK, right? He goes, dude. That is the first time I've seen Brittany, and I got to say, you guys did a great job. You could tell that you guys were having fun, and you two have chemistry, and I thought that meant a lot. So thank you, Kenny. Thank you, Kenny.
Yes, thank you.
See? People thought we had chemistry, and you're just rambling like, eh. And I'm like, I'll give you a part two. I have no problem with giving you a part two. I know you're going to bring it a little more after seeing what the hell I just did in this last one, so I expect nothing less, Brittany Savage. Well,
of course, there's going to be that chemistry. You're like, to me, you're like my little brother. I just want to, give you a noogie.
Yeah.
Listen, Michael.
Little noogie.
Listen, Michael.
Woman. So.
Yeah. See?
Yeah, we're friends. We have a great relationship. I mean, I've always said this. I mean, it's like, I said we're not married, but we fight like a married couple, which is hilarious. It's because it's banter. Yeah, well, someone said that to me. He's like, you guys sound like you're married. I'm like, we're not, but we act like it, right? And he's like, yeah. That's what it is. We kind of banter and argue like a married couple. It's funny. It's true. friggin' when your reality shows, man. I mean, just friggin' put us on a reality show, man. If you people want to see funny reality, just friggin' put this one on here. She'll be wiping down her kitchen or whatever it is. She's cleaning, shaking her booty to bye bye bye. I'll just be coming back and laughing at her with and it'll be that's a show. We need our own show, man. Not just podcast wise. Put us on reality TV. I know people would enjoy
that. We're friggin' real, man. Because I always say that, like, reality TV, that'd be fine with me, but I have, like, no time because of my actual work life to do things like that. But I can, dude, if I was able to do a reality TV show, like, our own reality TV show, you know how funny that would be?
With the two of us?
Yeah.
It would be very funny. It would be.
That'd be entertaining.
It would. And then there's the fact that we probably argue because you think I don't work well and that I'm a bum. You know, my job getting up at 10:30. I'm like, hey, it's just the schedule.
That you sleep late.
First and foremost,
it's waking up early at like 12 o'clock in the afternoon.
I don't wake up at 12. I wake up at like 9 or 10. Stop it.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
It was the shift. Okay. It was the shift. And then you got to tell me I'm just a jealous, lazy bum. Happy birthday, Polly. So, yeah.
Happy birthday, Polly.
What the heck is this?
You got me a robot?
Got me a robot? What the heck is this? And then friggin' he comes back. You're welcome, Polly. That's my girl.
Oh, the best. I love that movie. Rocky IV.
Rocky IV. But yes, you guys got the norm tonight with some Christmas, with everything. And I will say this, when it comes to Christmas, with everything that's going on in the world, I think we could say this because we've talked a lot. We talk our pop culture. We talk our Christmas. We talk our hilarity. We talk everything. But when it comes to Christmas, I know 2020 has not been the best year, but let's not remember that, to quote Elf, the best way to spread Christmas cheer is for each and everyone to hear, as you know. Everyone to hear, if you will. You know what I'm saying, Brittany Savage, Elf. You know what I'm talking about, Zooey Deschanel, Will Ferrell.
Yeah, okay. That's actually one film I haven't watched this year yet, so I definitely need to get on that.
Get on it. But with this times, we all got to remember that we got to, even though we can't, some of us can't be with our families, just try to enjoy Christmas for what it is, the holiday season of giving, and just try to have some cheer and try to shed some positivity, if you will, with all the negative and the bad stuff that's in this world. Because we need a little more love and positivity in this world. We need a little more Christmas right this very minute. We need a little more Christmas now. Hello.
It's true. What is your favorite Christmas song?
Oh, yes. We'll end it on that. All right. Jingle Bell Rock, Bobby Helm. Here Comes Santa Claus, Elvis Presley. NSYNC, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. 98 Degrees, This Gift is not bad. They did a not bad version of Let It Snow. Boyz II Men has a good version of Let It Snow. Rocking Around the Christmas Tree. Mamacita, Donde Está Santa Claus is a very popular one. I'm trying to think of what else. Yeah, there's so many. Oh, Nat King Cole, Christmas song, Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire. Luther Vandross does a great version of that, too. So I got a whole lot of them. I got a chunk of them, man. There's a lot of great ones. How about you?
Yeah, I was going to say, that's literally a lot of Christmas songs that you like. favorite. No, but I love all the Christmas songs, so I'm just like you. But favorite Christmas song? There would be, obviously, like, Blue Christmas from Elvis Presley.
That's a classic.
I love that song. And then Wonderful Christmas Time, Paul McCartney. That was my dad's favorite. Like, one of his
favorite. A Wonderful Christmas Time. Yep, that's a good one.
Yeah, so it's one of mine. And then, obviously, Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas Is You.
No.
I will forever love that song.
No. No, here's why. They constantly fucking play that. Every station, it's goddamn Mariah Carey. No, something else than Mariah fucking Carey all the goddamn time. I would rather listen to, you know what it is? And I fucking hate Josh Groban. But give me fucking Josh Groban after all over Mariah Carey all the damn time because I'm sick and tired of fucking Mariah Carey. I understand the song. I get it. But it's over fucking played.
All right. See, like, I understand where you're coming from, but, like, and I get it. Like, Walk 97.5. I know you're not from here anymore, but
shut up. I know the stations. Just be quiet. Don't do that. Don't do that. All right. It's going to be bad when I come down there. It's going to be bad. I'll give you a noogie. Shut up. Come on, go.
They play the same things over and over again a lot of the time. But to me, like, putting on the radio, listening to Walk 97.5, that, you know, it's Christmas time. But I agree. Like, they do overplay it a lot, but it's still, like, one of my favorites. So it doesn't bother me as much. And then there's Britney Spears, My Only Wish. And then and then there's obviously NSYNC, Happy Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays.
Those what about the other one? What about the other one from NSYNC?
Which one?
I Don't Want to Spend One More Christmas Without You.
Yeah, their whole Christmas album, honestly, was really good.
Oh, Holy Night a cappella is the shiznit.
What?
The Oh Holy Night a cappella that they did is the shiznit.
Their whole Christmas album was amazing. So good. Yes,
it was.
So good. You just reminded me I should actually download it onto my phone. Because I actually did enjoy that album so much.
What about 98 Degrees of This Gift and all those songs?
No.
Not a fan of 98 Degrees of This Gift?
See, I was a fan of 98 Degrees a little bit, but I wasn't like, I didn't like them as much as I liked Backstreet Boys and NSYNC and like Old Town.
We fit together, we want to go all night, ain't no stopping till the break.
On their big yacht boat.
Yes, I love that music video. You know what it is too? My mom loves that song too. And she, because one day she's like, who is this? And I'm like, Old Town, We Fit Together. And she liked that song ever since. She got it on her phone. Loves her some O-Town.
It's so good. O-Town is great. They were great, I should say.
Well, there's no more Ashley Parker Angel, so yes.
What do you mean?
He's not in the group anymore.
Oh my god, you said it as if he died.
No.
You're like, well, there's no more Ashley Parker Angel, and I was like, I'm okay.
Meaning like he's not in the group anymore. Common sense, put two and two together. Put two and two together.
I didn't even know that they were still a band.
Well, now you know. I think you can better recognize.
You made it sound like the guy passed away. That's why I was like, oh my god.
No. He's went solo. And there's no more O-Town. All right. But I mean, Liquid Dreams, All or Nothing. I have their album too. It's a good album.
Yeah, All or Nothing was one of the greatest songs that they had.
Because I want it all and nothing.
At 6 seconds. So good.
Yes. Brittany, I'm aware, man. I was around that time too. I was 9, but you were doing your thing at what, 14?
Wow.
You're welcome.
Oh man. I was 9. What, like 14? Yes. I was a teenager.
Yep.
I was.
Yes, we got to leave it on that note just because that was great and I'm proud of myself. So anyway.
You're always proud of yourself.
I am. <Woo. All right. laughs> So yes, people enjoy Christmas. All right. Last year I was very happy because before this COVID, I got to see the Rockefeller Center and go to the Radio City Music Hall. Still, every time you go see it, it was great. And also we got to eat at Ruth Chris, which was the shiznit in the city. Got me a good steak. It was a good night. But anyway, for those that are enjoying the festivities, do what you can, have fun, and just do what you can to just make out of this negativity and what the hell's been going on in this year that is 2020. And let me just say this. I think you can agree with me. Here's to a better 2021.
Oof. Ah. Okay.
Hoping.
I know we're heading off this. But every year, I always, like, buy a calendar, obviously, every year, right? Like, maybe in like November, usually I buy a calendar because I'm like, oh, okay, well, December's coming up. Like the year's coming to an end. I have not purchased the calendar yet this year because I'm just like, 2021 is happening. Hate to see what's coming next.
Okay.
Hopefully something better, but like,
I was trying to be optimistic, but the weirdo that you are is talking about how you buy a calendar every year. And I'm like, okay, that's nice.
You're optimistic, but I'm realistic.
Shut up. Just
why? That was a good one. Oh, damn. Burn, bitch. I'm just kidding.
You're so happy, aren't you? Yeah. Now this is what you get to expect in part two when we do this again. Oh my god. Ugh. Talk about how you sucked on the indies. You're not special. You're just a girl who played Mean Girl for 10 years. Yeah. True. Yeah.
It's true.
I didn't have to bring up the indie stuff, but hey, man, everybody was just like, you know what the problem that I had is? Everybody that cut a promo, she's a wrestler. And I'm just like, I knew your resume while all these other cats were playing catch up. Boom. See?
Yeah. It's facts. And I'm over here like, I'm sorry, I used to wrestle. What? I'm just kidding.
Save it for next year, man. You're going to be doing more promos with us next year, so that's going to be fun.
Yes, absolutely.
Ugh. So, yeah, we shall see. Expect more from Brittany in next year's tournament, which looks to be King of the Mic / Queen of the Mic, if Brittany's going to enter in the summer of 2021, which we've never had a Queen of the Mic. We've had two King of the Mics. The first one was me, and the second one is our current promo champion, Moses Marquez. So, yeah, man, see if we can get on up there with us.
Oh, get on up.
Get on up. Get on up. Get on up. Get on up. Yes. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Now you're gonna get me start singing Paul McCartney, and I love that song too. So good taste. There, last thing I'll say for Christmas songs, our family friend hated Eagles. Bells will be ringing.
Oh yeah, that's a good one too.
It is. Oh,
also this Christmas, but the Chris Brown version. That was a good one from the movie This Christmas. You remember that movie?
I do. It was a very good movie.
It was actually a really good movie. But that was a good song, too. The way he sings it, I liked it.
Yes, indeedy. So, in that regard, I will say this, because you're bringing back great memories. Now I just want to go watch movies, for God's sake.
People, I know, me too. I'm like, wow, I want to watch Four Christmases again.
People, make the most out of your holiday season. Enjoy it. And before we close this out, Brittany Savage, please promote the Facebook, the Twitter, the Instagram, where everybody can check you, as well as the Brittany Savage Show. Please go right ahead.
Oh, that poor show. RIP.
Yes, you have not posted a lot of material on that. That went to shit.
I have posted, no content. I will maybe get better at it. So we'll start with that, I guess. So YouTube channel that's supposed to happen, kind of is, is The Brittany Savage Show. Facebook is The Brittany Savage, as well as Instagram, The Brittany Savage, which is my newest Instagram. So please start requesting that one, because my other one is private still. Still say it every time. and then you can purchase a shirt at prowrestlingtees.com / Brittany Savage.
Okay. Now.
And then Twitter. Sorry. I don't remember it. It's
Brittany Savage. God. All right, say it, and I'll tell you if you're right. Twitter, go.
Is it The Brittany Sav, or is it The Brittany Sav?
The Brittany Sav, you could follow her on Twitter. She got it right.
Thank you. I had it right.
I was about to say, what if I am already a Brittany Savage guy and I don't even need to wear the merch? What about that?
Hey, that's fine.
I was trying to be nice with that because we're buddies, but then you're like, what if I'm already a Brittany Savage guy and I don't need the merch? Man.
Yeah, I mean, it's a cool shirt, though. It says The Brittany Savage Guy or The Brittany Savage Girl. Oh, no, not The Brittany. I'm a Brittany Savage Guy.
The Brittany. The Brittany.
You know, I based it off of what you said, like a ding dong. Or I'm a Brittany Savage Girl. And the Brittany. And then The Brittany Savage Show.
Which, somewhat.
It'll be up and running.
Kind of, maybe.
Kind of. It's kind of there.
Jesus. So if you want to check out yours truly, it's at SMShow1, MCL92, Pop_Culture_Pod for this show, LFC Pod on Twitter for the Lingerie Fighting Championships podcast, Beauty, Strength, and Dominance, three key elements to make women the work of art that they are. Check us out on WrestlingWithWrestling.com, Mr. Andre Corbeil putting up all the material. Check me out, StephenMikeShow.com, wherever you get your audio podcasting platforms for the LFC shows. I'm here, I'm there, I'm all over the place. Max Wrestling Podcast with my dudes, Dazzy Dangerously, Travis the Walker Anderson, and now the new reigning and defending promo champion, Mr. Moses Marquez, the Smart Mark. And Brittany will be on some more Max stuff next year. And it's going to be fun times, as always. Our part two will happen in the future. Brittany's going to be having new opponents, maybe same opponents around two who you face this year. It's been good times. It's been great memories, even through the negative times and the bad times. So check us out on the next edition of the Pop Culture History Podcast. And Brittany, do you have any final words? Because if we don't talk to them, we're just going to wish them a Merry Christmas.
Yes, Merry Christmas. Yes, absolutely. Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. Enjoy your time, like Michael said, with your family. Now is the time to really appreciate them even more so, given everything that we've been through in 2020. Still, Michael wants to be optimistic, but I'll be realistic. We don't know what the upcoming years are going to bring. So, again, appreciate everybody. Don't take people for granted. Live laugh, love, learn, whoop. Merry Christmas.
Beautifully said, but yes, realistic, optimistic, pessimistic. That's Brittany. So, I mean, so I will talk to you guys in the next episode, which will probably be, as we're recording this, probably be after Christmas, and we'll talk to you in the new year, because it's going to be a hectic couple of weeks before we get to holiday time, people. So enjoy your holidays. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. And we will talk to you in the next edition of the Pop Culture History Podcast. Brittany Savage, give them a whoop, whoop.
Whoop, whoop. Bye, guys.
Bye. Guys, later.